Hello everyone, welcome to chemistry class. We have been discussing the chapter number 3, elements, compound and mixtures. And in the last video, we had talked about the elements. The topic of elements we have already covered. In this present video, we will discuss about the remaining two type of substances, that is compounds and mixtures. You would be already having the live classes that are going on. So both the classes, that is in the live classes as well as the YouTube classes, both will continue side by side. So in this video, as I told, we'll discuss about compound and mixtures. In the last video, we talked about the elements. What the elements are, just for a recap, element is a substance that cannot be split. It cannot be broken into smaller or simpler substances. So that is by chemical means. We cannot break anything into small things or smaller substances. It is called an element. The ways to write an element are using symbols only. We can write symbols in case of elements, and writing symbols, for that we have three rules. I asked you to learn this table. You have to note it down in your copies. All three tables are given for the symbols that you have to note down and learn all the symbols. Then we talked in the last class about the molecules of an element, how the molecule is formed and how many atoms are present in a particular molecule. What is it called as? That particular phenomena is called as atomicity, that is the number of atoms which are present in a particular molecule. It is called atomicity, and atomicity is of different types that all we have seen in the previous class. So let us begin our today's video, that is about compounds and mixtures. So first the topic comes here is compound. What is a compound? It is any substance which can be split. Yes, apart from the, this is just opposite of the element. Element cannot be split, but in this case, we will say a compound is a substance which can be split into simpler substances by chemical means. Remaining same definition is there. The differences are between the element and compound is that we can say element cannot be broken into two parts, but compound can be broken. How it can be broken? That is by chemical means. Chemical means, we can say chemical change or chemical reaction has to be done. Otherwise, compound also cannot be broken. If we do any physical process, then compound cannot be broken. By any chemical reaction, yes, it is possible to break the compound into two parts. Let us see here. That is given here, example is given. For example, a mixture of hydrogen and oxygen on being kindled form water. So H2, that is hydrogen, and O2, that is water. If we combine both of them and kindle them, that is if we keep them on heating or keep them on burning, then they will give us water, that is H2O will form. Similarly, we can also have another example. Carbon burn in oxygen forms carbon dioxide. Carbon is C. So when it is burned in oxygen, that is it combines with oxygen, that we will get CO2 gas. Another third example now, sulfur on being burned forms sulfur dioxide. Sulfur is S. When it is also burned, then it will give SO2 gas. Whenever I speak burning, that means it is combining with oxygen. Whenever anything is burning, it means the reaction is taking place with oxygen. Without oxygen, nothing can burn. So we can say it is addition of oxygen only. Whenever something is burning, it is addition of oxygen. In other terms, we can say. Now, how are compounds represented? In the case of symbols, we discussed that the symbols are used for elements. That is different symbols we have seen. But in the case of the compound, we will not write the symbols. Rather, we will use the symbols to make formulas. That is, different symbols are written together that are present in a particular compound. The elements which are present in a compound, their symbols are written together. And when they are written together, then we will say that it is a formula. What is a formula? It is like this. You can see here, water. Water is made of hydrogen and oxygen. Two things are there. So, hydrogen and oxygen. So because hydrogen and oxygen combine there, so that is why in the formula of water, both the symbols will come, hydrogen also, water also. So this will make the formula for this particular compound. Similarly, different formulas are given that you have to read through in the book. All these are the different formulas. So what we just now learned, that is compound, are represented by writing in the form of formulas. Instead of writing the full name of the compound, we can write the short formulas. In chemistry, that is the language of chemistry also, we can say, that is formulas and symbols. So for compound, we write formulas. For element, we write symbols. So that is all. Now, what this information is provided, if someone is, if we have only the formula, if only the formula is written, then what information can be provided? So that you can mark this line in the book, that is the formula of the compound indicates. What does it tell? It tells how many atoms of any element are present in a molecule. What is important here is, it tells how many atoms are there, of which element, of one element, of a particular element, how many atoms are participating to form this molecule. For example, one molecule of water, if you have to write one molecule of water, we will write H2O. And H2O means how many atoms are there for hydrogen. Now you notice the number here, hydrogen, two atoms are given. So we can directly assume that two atoms are present of hydrogen. Similarly, in the case of oxygen, no number is not written, rather we can say only one is there. So one atom of oxygen, so two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen is present, and it is forming H2O or water. Similarly, carbon monoxide, the formula you can see CO. So one atom we can say of carbon and one atom is of oxygen. So that is how we can count the number of atoms. One more, you see SO2. S means sulfur, that is sulfur atom. So one atom of sulfur is there, and after that O2 is written. So two atoms are there, one atom of sulfur and two atoms of oxygen are present in this particular thing. But in the downwards next compound you can see SO3, sulfur trioxide. So sulfur one atom is there and three atoms are of oxygen. So this is how different formulas are written. Many more are written given in the book only, that you can notice on page 21 in your book. You can find this table, and it is telling what it is giving us, the information of how many atoms are there in this particular compound. These all are various formula. The formula are given, and what they are telling, they are indicating the number of atoms that are participating to form this compound. So we learn the definition of the compound, that is important, you have to learn this. Then second thing, what is the method to represent the compound, that is formula. And next one, we have learned what this formula is telling us. It is telling us how many atoms are there of a particular element in a compound. Now let us go to the characteristics of the compound. First point here is given, a compound can be split, or that means what, it can be broken into constituent element only by chemical means. Only and only by chemical reaction we can break the compound into two parts. If we do the physical process, then compound cannot break. For example, physical process example for that is filtration. Now water is a compound. If we do the filtration of water, then what will happen? We will get pure water. Water on filtering will become pure. Water will not, it will not happen that in the filter we are putting water and we are getting hydrogen and oxygen. It is not possible. Water can break into hydrogen and oxygen. It is possible, but it can be done only by a chemical means, or we can say chemical reaction should be done. Otherwise, it will not happen. Like filtration. Filtration is a physical method. It is not a chemical reaction. So, because filtration is not a chemical reaction, it will not break water into hydrogen and oxygen. Water will still remain water, only it will become pure. So by physical means, what we have learned in this point, by physical means compound cannot be broken. It can be broken into constituent element only and only by the chemical means. Second point, now elements combine in a fixed proportion of their atoms. That means number of atoms is fixed. How many atoms will be in a particular compound, that is fixed. Like in H2O, we are always writing the formula H2O for water. We never write H3O or H2O4. All these are wrong. This cannot be called as water. Only H2O is called as water. So this will give us a fixed number of atoms, that is here you can see two atoms of hydrogen and one atom is of, number is not written, so it means one. So one atom of oxygen is always there. If this number of atoms is not in this ratio, that is 2:1, two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of oxygen. If 2:1, this ratio of atom is not followed, then water cannot form. If we do not take hydrogen and oxygen atom in this ratio, then water will not form. So that is the point they are telling, that elements will combine to form a compound. Elements combine to form compounds, that is okay, but they will only combine when the number of atoms is in a fixed proportion. That means we can say a fixed ratio is there. If that ratio is maintained, then compound will form. If that ratio is not maintained, compound will not form. Similarly, just like the hydrogen and oxygen, I told you 2:1, one more is given here. Carbon combines with oxygen in the ratio 1:2. 1:2 means one atom of carbon combined with two atoms of oxygen. So one atom of carbon and two atom of oxygen, what will form? It will give us CO2. If we take opposite now, if we take two atom of carbon and one atom of oxygen, then CO2 will not form, something else will form. So that is carbon monoxide will form. So that we don't have to worry. So that is the point, the number two, or the property second, that is fixed proportion of atoms are always there, then only elements will combine and compound will form. Now after the number of atoms, their fixed ratio we have seen. Now there is one more ratio that is followed, that is fixed proportion of mass is there. Different atoms are having particular mass, that is in grams. Every atom is having some mass, that is in grams, and whenever elements are combining, there is a fixed proportion of mass. That means this particular gram of atoms will combine with this particular gram of atoms. For making it more clear, let us see the same example of water which we are using. When we see the number of atoms, then we say 2:1, 2 atom hydrogen and 1 atom oxygen should be there to form water. But when we are seeing the proportion by mass, then what we will say? Then there is another ratio, that is 1:8. That means 1 gram hydrogen and 8 gram water should be there. Sorry, oxygen, I said wrong. 1 gram hydrogen and 8 grams oxygen should be there. If this ratio is not maintained, then water will not form. Suppose we take 1 gram hydrogen and we take 2 gram oxygen. So ratio kya ho jata hai? Then in this case, ratio will become 1:2. But what is needed here for making water? 1:8 should be there. It is not being followed in 1:2. So if we take 1 gram hydrogen and 2 gram oxygen, water will not form. So basically what they want to say, if we have to prepare water using a chemical reaction, then we have to take 1 gram hydrogen, the mass of the hydrogen atom should be 1 gram, and mass of the total oxygen atom, all the oxygen atom combined together which we have taken, should be of 8 grams. And when we combine this, what we will get? We will get water. And what will be the mass of water molecule? Now you can see the number are written 8 and 1 gram hydrogen and 8 gram oxygen. If they both will combine, they will join together, so we will get 1+8, that means 9 gram of water will be formed. Similarly, another equation is given, another reaction is given. If we take 3 gram carbon, and it will react with 8 gram of oxygen, means 3 gram carbon that is being taken, 3 gram is the mass of carbon atoms that is being taken, and it is reacted with oxygen. Oxygen we have taken 8 grams. So ratio is 3:8 now. So total what will form? 11 grams of what will form? 3+8 is 11. So 11 grams of CO2 gas will form. So carbon and oxygen produce CO2 gas. When they are reacting, when carbon is burning, CO2 is produced. So, but it will produce in a fixed proportion of mass only. That is, carbon should be 3 gram, oxygen should be 8 gram. So this is the point number 2, that element combine in a fixed proportion of mass. So there is a law also, that is already I have told you, that is the mass of the compound is the sum of the mass of the element. Whatever the elements are there, their mass is equal to the compound mass. Element, like here you can see, element are what? Hydrogen is element, oxygen is element, and their particular mass, you can see hydrogen mass is 1 gram, oxygen mass is 8 gram. So mass of element, jo bhi elements ka mass hota hai, usko hum add kar dete hain. So addition of the mass of elements will give us what? It will give us the mass of compound, that is 9 gram water. So formula will become what? It will become, I'll write here, sum of mass of elements, all the elements mass is added together, and it will give us what? It is equal to the mass of compound. So sum of masses of elements is equal to the mass of compound. Point number 4, the last property we will see, the properties of the compound are entirely different than those of its constituent elements. Yes, the properties directly change when the compound is there. Compound is having one particular property, means its behavior is something fixed, that is called its property. how it is behaving, how it is reacting with other things. That is called property. And the properties of elements are rather different. For understanding this, again, we'll use the example of water only. Water is forming from hydrogen and oxygen. You can see here. Now, water, you observe, water is a fire extinguisher. Whenever fire is there and you throw water, fire will turn off. That means water does not support burning. Whenever fire is there, we use it for turning off the fire. Water is a fire extinguisher. Now, this water is forming from two things, hydrogen and oxygen. Now, let us see the property of hydrogen. Hydrogen gas, does it support burning? Yes. In fact, hydrogen is an explosive gas. It burns very fastly. It burns readily. So, hydrogen gas can be burned. It is written there. Next one, oxygen gas. Does it support? Yes. Oxygen gas is also required for burning. In fact, it is the most compulsory gas. If this gas is not in the air, then nothing will burn. No fire can take place anywhere if oxygen gas is not there. So, oxygen gas is an important element required for burning to take place. So, hydrogen and oxygen, both are supporting fire, but when they combine together, they should also support fire, but the property has changed. Hydrogen and oxygen, when they are alone, when they are element, they support fire, but when they combine together to form water, then the behavior is changed. That is, water is a fire extinguisher. So properties have changed. In element, some other property. In compound, some other properties there. Similar example is given, carbon and oxygen. Carbon can be burned. Carbon example, like coal. You can burn coal and it produces heat. In the winter season, people burn coal and they get heat. So carbon can be burned, and oxygen, already we know now that it supports burning. So carbon and oxygen both are supporters of combustion. Both are supporting burning. Combustion means burning only. So carbon and oxygen both can support burning. But when they combine together, and a gas that is CO2 is formed, carbon dioxide is formed. But the carbon dioxide is having some other behavior. It is a fire extinguisher. So this gas does not support fire. If anywhere fire is breaking out and you supply carbon dioxide, that fire will turn off. So this is what is actually produced from the fire extinguisher cylinders. There are certain, you might have observed, red color cylinders are kept in various buildings and offices. So in the school also you can find. So this gas is being produced there. When we open that particular cylinder, that fire extinguisher cylinder, CO2 gas is being produced there. And this CO2 is used to turn off the fire. So what we learned just now, that is, the property has changed. You see, in the reactant side, the elements carbon and oxygen both are supporting fire. But when they combine to become a compound in our example is carbon dioxide. So in this compound, the property has changed. That is, carbon dioxide is a fire extinguisher. It does not support fire. So that is all. Point 4 we have learned. All four properties are complete about the compounds. Now we will move to the topic of mixtures, and let us see it. We'll see the definition part. First of all, what is a mixture? Mixture is anything which can be separated into two or more pure substances, and it is done by physical method. Now chemical method is not needed for separating the mixtures. We can use simple physical methods like filtration, decantation, sublimation, and so on. Many methods are there in this chapter. Later on we will see that. So what is a mixture? Anything or any substance which can be split into two or more substances. And generally the mixtures are split into two parts. They are split into the two parts, which are called as the pure substances. What are pure substances now? Pure substances are of two types. One is element, another one is compound. So pure substance means element and compound. So basically what we can say, that mixtures are forming by the combination of elements and compounds only. Different elements combined together, they will give mixtures, or different compounds combined together, they will also give mixtures. Thirdly, we can say different elements and compound all mixed together, they will also produce a mixture. So mixture example, we can have in our nature many type of mixture. Natural mixtures are there. For example, air. The air around us is a mixture of various gases. In the room where you are sitting right now, air is there, and we are breathing this air regularly. So this air is a mixture of different gases. Many gases are there, like oxygen gas we are breathing. Other than that, nitrogen is there, carbon dioxide is there, water vapor is there. So air is a mixture of different gases. Also we can say air is a mixture of element and mixture, because element and compound like oxygen and nitrogen, these two are what? These are the elements. These are the elements that are present in air. Other than this, carbon dioxide and water vapor, these are what? Carbon dioxide is CO2 and water vapor means H2O. These are what? These are compounds. So same air only, air is having element also, compound also. Element oxygen, nitrogen, compound CO2 and H2O. Likewise, we can say many elements and many compounds are present in the same mixture. Another example is given here, that is ordinary water, the normal water that is used in our day-to-day life. It is also a mixture, it is having different minerals in it. Different minerals are naturally present in the normal water or the ordinary water. Which type of minerals are there? Minerals of calcium and magnesium are there. Different minerals are present there, which will give some taste to the water. You might have observed when you drink water at different places, some change is coming in the taste. That taste of the water is actually changing due to the presence of minerals only. At different regions, at different areas, different amount of minerals may be there. Some place some more minerals are there, some places some less minerals are there. So that will change the shape, the taste of the water. So accordingly, the water can be changing due to the presence of minerals in it. Another example is sea water, that is for the minerals. Sea water is also a mixture. What is the sea water having? It is having a large number of salts. Many salts are there. Even the common salt that we use in our food, it is also present in sea water. From the sea water only, by the process of evaporation, we are getting the common salt. That is, manufacturing of common salt is done. That is what is sold in the market. Next one is all the soils, rock, minerals, everything around us, is all these things are mixture of different substances. Even our own body also, the plant body, animal's body, and also the human being's body are made up of different substances, or we can say we are also a mixture of different substances. Our body is having different nutrients. We are eating the food daily, and these nutrients are being absorbed by our body. So our body is also possessing different kinds of mixtures. Last two examples are given, milk and blood. These are also examples of mixtures. So this is all about the mixtures. Introduction we have seen. Next video we will continue this topic. That is all for today's video. The properties of mixture, types of mixtures, we will see in the next class. That is all for today. Thank you.